Hello, hello, hello. Tile, subject of the video today. A little bit of education about different types of tile. In the olden days, back when there used to be big houses with clay tile roofs. Now, clay tile is different than the concrete tile we make in America. By the way, this is Brad Kittel, or Darby Letic, or a number of different things. We'll decide later when we edit it, won't we? He's going to be speaking too, both of them. But right now, Darby's telling you about tile. Ta-da! Okay, the first one we're going to talk about is the newest of the tile selections. This is actually out of Japan. It's about 45, 50 years old now, and it's really thick. It's able to take extremely heavy hits. Hail, that's cobalt, hand glazed on there in Japan. Okay, now this is the back of one of those. And for those who like labels and symbols and all that good stuff, that's who made it and made in Japan. Hand glazed, cobalt, one of the toughest materials, and you see it on all the temples, all over. Now, just for good looks, I want to go ahead and make sure we wiped it down so you can see what that looks like. Now, that'll last and not mold or mildew. Why is that important? Because if you have the other kinds of tile, which a lot of people have, that's over here, that's green Ludovici, and that's older, and this is a clay tile. Now you see a lot of this out there from Mexico, and it has some advantages as well. It's a little brittle, but the biggest problem with it is that it holds dirt, holds mold, and you have to pressure wash it or clean it regularly to keep from having huge buildups. When I was in Florida, we used to have to pressure wash roofs all the time because of the clay that would hold the mildew and snag things. So in some areas, some tiles are good, in some areas, some tiles are not. Now, the oldest tile, that's probably, again, 50 years old, new old stock, it's been salvaged. Actually, that was salvaged off of the officers' club in San Antonio. And as they closed it down, they had a roof on it, put about $8 million into making the thing. And it lasted less than 7 years, or $15 million was wasted on that officer's club over a matter of a few years. But anyway, that was the tile roof off of it. Now, this is a Ludovici tile. I had this brought in a long time ago from Missouri. I was on a trip and saw it, fell in love with it, and had him bring it down to me. Ludovici is an Italian tile, and it actually started long before this tile was made, as companies in Europe do. But notice the amount of engineering and stuff into the tile. It's got a weep hole and tracks, and this is a channel, so that each piece, as it lays over the next one, you get a chance to see then how you would be able to keep the water the way it's designed. That was that chip out of it, so that you keep the water from flowing. Okay, now these are all numbered on how they go together. Then this is also an example of what tile with this kind of finish does under heavy, heavy hail. Those are hits from hail, most likely ages ago. Still didn't leak, but wasn't as pretty. Now this is a J8, and each of these has a spot that they will go in. You can't just lay them all. There's some that are opposite lay, some are corners, and that's how they numbered it. So this channel keeps the water that gets behind here from going under and into the house. This is going to drop, and you've got a little thing on there to make it drop better and flow better. The detail on these are amazing. A little channel, and then that catches it. So each one, the next row, then covers that. And so over each channel drops into the next channel, etc., etc., until you have a beautiful covering in a beautiful green you cannot buy in new material today. So that's the green Ludovici, and as far as the dating and stuff on this, they were always very nice about that. So you can see Ludovici T12, patent July 19, 1898, patent March 17, 1903, means they renewed their patent. And so this was a patented color at the time, a patented build. See how structurally how they have this all strengthened in the back with ribs and prevention so the wind is blowing, it can't blow the water up underneath into the next trail. It's extremely well designed, and consequently, they don't make anything like that anymore. So if you wanted some Ludovici to patch up something after the storms, and you have one of those old houses, that's only part of it. I have more. This, much less expensive. Something like this, you're looking at least $300 a square, 10 foot by 10 foot area. $400 a square is reasonable, given you're going to pay double that in these days. This came in the country at $750 a square, meaning 10 foot by 10 foot area coverage and field. And this is the trim. That's one of the caps you can use to cover your ridges and your hips. Now, I have another type here on your side. See that? Top profile. That is another clay tile. Now, this particular clay tile is out of Texas. This one came out of actually Gonzales, Texas. And it was off of a real nice doctor's house. And now, what's interesting about this too, it has the same sort of channeling, each piece locking into the next. See how this is done? So if you lift them up right, you can take them apart. And that way, when it rains, this channel catches all the water flow, one row to the next. So as they go over each other, you get that same sort of benefit. But on these, you can stagger them. And in that way, the drop of this drain is on this area instead of being in the channel and overriding the channel. So it's a different way to lay. But another issue with this one is it's a brushed clay. And while beautiful and having many advantages, if you have a bunch of algae or pecan trees over the top or something like that, they're going to tend to snag stuff flowing down it and cause you have a little bit of problems. So that has one not so good effect if you have the wrong area for it. Out in the open, not so much of a problem. And I do have a good bit of it. I think I'm maybe 1,000 square feet, which would do about a 700 square foot house. This is a low pitch, medium pitch, but not a high pitch roof. Two screws or copper nails, brass nails, probably nowadays get more expensive. So I'd use Torx screws and just screw them in. And you can go along and just lay them over gaps even. You have wood lath and a underlayment and then another piece of wood lath. And these are designed just to sit on the wood lath and have a gap in it and have another piece of lath. Now, that doesn't allow for any insulation underneath it, but you're laying it typically over some very strong 2x8 joists or beams that have the lath on them so that they can carry the loads that these will require. These are going to weigh in at probably, 4 pounds, 3 pounds a piece. Some of those others weigh in even more because of the thickness of them. You can see on the green Ludovicis. And incidentally, it takes about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, for example. If there's 6 there, every 2 of them is probably going to give you about 1.5 feet of coverage. As opposed to the bigger tile, like these, in which case you have a bit of a larger overcover, but you still lose this much and this much. So the exposed area is how you measure a square, is about to cover 100 square feet. That's going to take more than 100 square feet of tile, 10 foot by 10 foot area, to cover it. And when you come out the end of it, you want to top it off something so it doesn't leak in the top. And that's what something like that would be at the top of your ridge. And so one goes on the other and flows it down. Anyway, this is the idea behind using tile instead of composition shingles or metal or other materials for a number of reasons. One of them is that this type of tile will sustain pretty substantial hits with hail and not break. The glazed Italian tiles, for example, and the glazed Japanese tile. These will still resist much better the hits from hail than the modern concrete tile, unless you get into the super bonder polymer based tiles they make it for the coast now that are supposed to be able to take hurricanes, which is great, but there are issues with that too. For the moment, I just want to let everybody know this is going to be available. I'm going to sell some of this. I'm not sure which. I've also got a few other things I'm getting ready to offload. These are 4x4s, longleaf pine, some of them 20 foot long, 1x12s, in the form of barn wood, in the form of tongue and grooves, 1880s bead boards, beams of various sorts. All this is being moved over from Gonzales. And as you can see, there's an awful lot of it and enough to spare for some other people to come by. Oh, those are cool. Those are rafters, by the way. And then, just so you know, there is a little bit more of that other tile. 32,000 square feet, or say 30,000 square feet of the blue tile is in stock. And then there's going to be 3,200 maybe square feet of that clay tile, which means an average house in this day and age, hopefully several small houses. And then Ludowice is a pile over there and a pile over here and what was out there, and that's the end of the Ludowice. So I'm going to say that's probably going to be a small house or an outbuilding or a cottage in the woods. Now that's more the flat tile, again, great for cottages in the woods. You can push it to a higher, steeper pitch if you want, just have to build for it. There's some more. So I probably have 1,000 square feet coverage in that tile. I said, I think 3,200, I may be overestimating this because I don't know what my breakage is. So guys, oh, and there's some cool brick too, some gross becks. That's an orange brick, there's a pallet. There's another pallet of the orange tile and another one. And another one, and another one. So, interested? These are already pre-cuts, so you can use them for valleys and things like that. You want to do that, not have to cut them if you don't want to. Alrighty, thank you so much. You guys, appreciate it. Sorry I didn't have this pointing at me the whole time, but the other lens is broken worse than this one is. I do appreciate your help, your time, sharing if you can. And tell people, we got some of this stuff sitting around that I want to go ahead and share with other people. Look at this, it just caught my attention. This is actually a cabinet set. See the doors? These are fronts for a corner cabinet. Needs glass. And then there's this thing right there. And look at that door. I actually have the top for that. And it's actually got stained glass all around the top and the sides. Oh, we still need to do something with that. Anyway, y'all have a great day.